In this video, I'm going to share some websites that you really need to check out. Now, some have been life-changing for me. Some are time savers, and some are just fun. Let me know if you're using any of these sites and if you have other website recommendations of your own. Just comment below and let me know. Let's jump in. Number one, check if you've been hacked. Data breaches happen more often than we know. Your login to different websites can be stolen. Now, this usually involves your email ID and your password too. Now, it happened to me some years ago with one of my logins. I only found out from this website that I'm going to show you in a second. Now, this isn't something that just affects a few people. It's happening and it's already happened on a huge scale. In February 2019, the email validation service, verifications.io, suffered a data breach which affected more than 760 million accounts. Now, Facebook also had a case where in April 2021, a data set of over 500 million users was made freely available for download. So yes, you can be impacted too. Now here's a website that lets you check this. It's called Have I Been Pwned? It lets us check whether our personal data has been compromised by a data breach. It was created as a free resource by Troy Hunt, who's a fellow Microsoft MVP and regional director. Enter your email address and the website will check against a collected list of all known data breaches with records tied to that email address. Hopefully you're going to see that everything is fine. If not, you're going to be informed about the breaches that impacted you. In this case, it means that the security of your account was compromised on these sites, and you should definitely change the passwords for these accounts. Also, make sure that you don't use that same password on other platforms. It also doesn't hurt to scan your system for viruses and malware. Have I Been Pwned also has a feature where you can sign up to be notified if your email address appears in future data leaks. Highly recommended. Number two, test your hearing. Now, I don't know if you've seen these videos, especially on TikTok, they're all over the place. It's the videos where they claim that only people under 25 can hear this sound. Now, sometimes I can hear them and sometimes I can't hear anything. I'm nowhere close to 25. And then I start to wonder, is my hearing really okay? Now, it's true that with age, we lose the ability to hear certain high frequency sounds. But exposure to noise or our genetics or an infection can also lead to hearing loss. A more sophisticated way than listening to a TikTok video is an online hearing test. A great non-commercial website is hearit.org. There you can do a short 5-step speech and noise test. It's anonymous and no email address is required to take the test. It will assess how good you are at hearing numbers in noisy environments. It's best to use headphones for the test though. At the end, you'll get a percentage result of your speech understanding. Now I did the test a few times, some were 97%, and the last test I did where I was recording the screen turned out to be 100%. It's a simple quick test that you can do at home to test your hearing. Obviously, for a more accurate result, you should visit a medical professional. Number three, install and update. Setting up a new computer or a laptop is very time consuming. Now, we all have different software and apps that we use. Finding the publisher's official site, downloading, and then going through all this install process for each of these apps separately is a real pain. Now, wouldn't it be nice if you could pick what you need from a selection and everything is installed simultaneously in the background? With a website called nightnight.com, you can do just that. It offers a variety of different apps, from web browsers, messaging apps, imaging tools, to security and compression software. Just select what you need and get your nightnight. Nightnight will make sure that you receive the most up-to-date official version of your apps. And there is another great benefit. Any bloatware that's optional when you download is ignored and blocked. Now, I value that because I'm used to clicking next, 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 and then I end up installing some additional toolbar just because I didn't uncheck an option. Number four, find alternatives. Software is often expensive. So when you're on a tight budget, or if you're looking to replace one of your favorite apps that was recently discontinued, a free service called AlternativeTo can help. Just go to the search box and type in a program name. It's going to suggest similar alternatives. Then use the filters to narrow down your search. Select a platform, certain features, and if you're looking for a free, open source, or paid alternative. Once you've found your alternative, you can download it from the link provided. Number 5, pictures speak louder than words. We've heard that before, and we've seen it work. Images that support our presentation or our social media posts help us get our story and our message across. But where do you find these pictures? Now, of course, there are platforms for stock photography like Shutterstock or iStock, but they can get quite expensive. A great free alternative is a website called Pixabay. They offer a vast variety of images, illustrations, vector graphics, videos, and even some music. In total, over 2.3 million items, and all of them are copyright free and released under the simplified Pixabay license, which means they can be used for both commercial and non-commercial purposes, completely free. Now that said, there are a few exclusions to the free use of Pixabay images, so be sure to check out what is not allowed. But generally, the licensing is simple and straightforward, and there are only a few other resources out there that offer such an extensive collection of high-quality stock photography. Number 6, find out who you are and what makes you tick. Personality tests can be a fun way to find out what really drives, inspires, and worries different personality types. With a website called 16personalities.com, you can take a free test to maybe better understand the strengths and weaknesses related to your own personality. No sign up or registration is needed here. Just click on Take the Test and answer the questions.
A few moments later.
When you're done, you're going to get an assessment of your personality type. I'm apparently a defender. You can explore more about your type and find out about strengths and weaknesses, relationships, workplace habits, and so on. The test is available in 30 languages, and it can give you valuable insights as long as you're answering honestly and you don't select neutral answers too often. So feel free to share your result below in the comments. It's going to be fun to see these. Number 7, plan your meals. Meal planning can sometimes be a pain, especially if you need to consider specific diet goals like maximum calories. EatThisMuch.com can help you with that. Just select your food preference. I'll go with Mediterranean, then how many calories you want to eat in a day. If you're not sure, you can also use this nutrition calculator to figure out your targets. Then select how many meals per day you want to have. I'm going to go with 3. Now let's click on Generate, and it's going to suggest a meal plan. If you're not happy with it, you can regenerate the entire day or just individual meals. When you click on a meal, it will list the ingredients and directions as well as some nutrition facts. The recipes are tasty, and by getting some ideas on what to cook makes it easier to eat healthier. Number 8, find the right answer. Most of us use Google search to find what we need. Now it's a great search engine, it's going to give you plenty of results to your question. And then it's up to you to find the answer that best fits your question. But for certain topics like maths, science, or nutrition, you can also use a website called WolframAlpha. It gives you specific answers based on curated data instead of pages full of search results. So let's say you want to cook a turkey. So in the search box here, we type in time to cook a 20-pound turkey. It's 4.5 hours. Check this out. It's also going to give you more information, like a chart with the cooking time versus weight, thawing time, and even some nutritional info. Let's try something else. Let's compare the sugar in Coke versus Fanta. And we get the results and the nutrition facts below. You can also do math questions like this. And the result is right here. Now, as a side note, Microsoft has also partnered with Wolfram to bring this information as new data types to Excel. Number 9, animate your photo. An amazing website is MyHeritage. They offer an AI tool called Deep Nostalgia, which creates realistic video footage from still photos. On their website, click on Upload Photo. The service is free, but you need to sign in with an email address. Now, I already did that, so I'm just going to select this picture of my grandparents. Now, it's going to process and enhance the image. Once your animated video is ready, it's going to start playing. If there's more than one face detected, you can select them here. You can also share and download the created video. It's quite amazing. Deep Nostalgia is also available as an app from the App Store or Google Play. Number 10, find something to watch. Sometimes I spend what feels like hours trying to figure out what movie to watch next. Then when I finally narrowed it down, I check whether it's available on the platforms that I watch movies on. Sometimes it's not, and then the search begins all over again. So yeah, I waste a lot of time on search. But then I found a good movie to watch. This is a website which recommends highly rated movies and movies that aren't so well known. It includes staff picks and is curated by actual people. So if you want to get exposed to some new things that are outside of your standard Netflix recommendations, make sure you check it out. Now, there's some really amazing stuff out there. If you have some other websites that you like a lot, please share them with us below in the comments. I hope you enjoyed this video. Please give it a thumbs up if you did, and consider joining our community by subscribing if you haven't already done so. Many thanks for watching, and I'm going to see you in the next video. We'll be right back.